personally needs our compassion, and it urges us to respond to those needs in imitation of His love, His compassion, and His care. And I know you chose this gospel because you felt it spoke of your mother's own journey of faith. You described your mother, Alice, to me as a very warm and welcoming person who loved her family and really lived her faith. God truly blessed her with a very long life. And she sought, as you explained to me, to find joy every day in her children, in her grandchildren, the people she encountered every day, but most especially you, her family. She always took an interest, she told me, in other people. Not just yourself, but your friends and those who gathered with you. She wanted to know how they were doing. She thought of them. She prayed for them. She remembered them. She was known for her compassion, and she felt for people who experienced losses in their own life. She was very generous to her charities. I know that you explained to me how Alice graduated from Emmanuel College, and through these many years since her graduation, she would get together with her classmates every year. She loved that because she kept that contact, she kept that bond with those people who were part of her life. It kind of speaks about the kind of person she was. She loved as well, most of the time, the New England Patriots. I guess not all the time. She loved the Kentucky Derby. I guess that was a very special event. But she loved gathering with you and family. That was made it very special. You told me that she shared great advice with all, and her biggest advice, turn to God in tough times. To always trust that God will provide for you. Finally, Alice was a woman of great faith who drew great strength from the Eucharist. As I understand it, when she received the Eucharist most recently at home, she was just overwhelmed each time she received it. So special did she feel that gift was for her on her journey. She really, as you explained to me, lived her faith. Now we gather here to give thanks to God for all the blessings that you've received through Alice. And we pray now that she rests in God's peace forever and ever.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the souls of Alice's
See. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her beloved spouse, the apostles, the martyrs, Saint Michael, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
For through him, and with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. In confidence, we pray now in the words that Jesus teaches us to pray. Our Father.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously, grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress. As we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom.